Hey, what's up, everybody? I had a few guys ask me about double clutching, which all in a nutshell that double clutching is just releasing the clutch so that the clutch and the flywheel can touch each other while it is out of gear, and it can match the engine RPMs to the speed of the back tires is all that you're doing. It's actually much easier to do in a semi because the engine is a lot slower. The RPMs don't go up and down as quick. So it's easier to do, but I attempted to do it in my F-350 straight drive 5-speed, and it was a little bit tougher actually, because you have to be a lot quicker with your feet. Done the best I could with the lighting and the camera angle. I put it on a tripod that moved around a little bit more than I would have liked, and it was about 5:30, so it's starting to get kind of dusk. But done the best I could. Hope it helps you out in your double clutching adventures. And at the end, I showed that actually, you can drive a 5-speed without the need of a clutch. You can just kind of float them in as long as you match the RPMs around 1,800, I would say. So here's the video. Check it out and leave comments if you like. Maybe whenever I actually get a job and I can get going with this, I'll make one from the actual semi-truck and show how it is from there. Maybe then I can get a little better camera angle and a little better lighting. So talk to you guys later. Leave some comments, leave some ratings, whatever you want to do, and we'll catch you later. We'll see ya. Okay, so double clutching. First time's going to be a little slow. Get the truck up to speed. Take it out of gear, let it drop back down. Get back into gear, come back out. Just like that. Alright, let's go one more. Out, out. Put it back into gear, and in. Just like that. Alright, so I'm gonna pull over now. Try to, anyways. A lot of traffic out here. Picked the wrong time of the day. Alright, we're gonna try it a little quicker. Get up to speed so if I can go through them a little bit better. Okay, here we go. Alright, now downshifting. Whenever you get up about a little bit over 2200 RPMs, put it back in fourth gear. Alright, we're up at 2200. I'm going to slow down to around 1100. Okay, come up, rev up, back in. Just like that. We're at 2200. Slow down to 1100. Okay. So let's try and do that all the way down now. Here we go. So in a completely dirty nutshell, that's just about how it is, upshifting and downshifting. There's a lot of traffic out on the road, I can't do it as much as I would like. try that. Sometimes you have to ask yourself, if all that downshifting and upshifting is just a kind of a match of the RPMs of the engine and the spinning of the back wheels, shouldn't we just be able to do this without a clutch? So let's try and float them in, shall we?